So consider the following situation. Suppose you had two wire loops in close proximity to one another. If a time-invariant current flows around the first loop, it will generate a magnetic field. If a second time-invariant current flows around the second loop, this second current will experience a force due to the magnetic field of the first loop. It has been experimentally shown that the force experienced by a differential element of the second current loop is given by this equation. In this equation, A sub r is the unit vector pointing from the field source current element of the first loop to the force receiving current element of the second loop, and capital R is the distance between those two current elements. By comparing this to our original force equation, we can pull out this expression for the magnetic field of the first loop. This is Biot-Savart's law for a one-dimensional current. Notice that this equation only depends on the properties of the first loop. The numerator says that the field is proportional to the current in the loop and oriented perpendicularly to the direction of current. The denominator says that the field grows weaker as you get farther away from the source, with a decay rate proportional to 1 over r squared. As we've done before, we can express the unit vector A sub r and the distance capital R in terms of the vectors r, which points from the origin to the field observation point, and r prime, which points from the origin to the field source. This gives us this equation for the total magnetic field due to a single loop of time-invariant current. Magnetic fields add linearly, so we can use superposition to find the total magnetic field due to any arbitrary current distribution. This, then, is the general form of Biot-Savart's law, which accounts for all possible combinations of current distributions. It should be noted that this equation is only true if the field source currents are not changing with time.